You might call them nature's real-life blue bloods. Horseshoe crabs, ungainly creatures, uniquely valuable to humankind. Conor Knighton has the story of a species.
Located between Delaware and New Jersey, the tranquil waters of the Delaware Bay offer a bit of calm compared to the open ocean. But for a couple of months each year, there is a chaotic party on the beach. The bay is home to the world's largest population of horseshoe crabs.
Are they looking for mates at this point? What's
they
happening?
They are. These are all males mostly, and they're looking for a female.
Lisa Ferguson is the director of research and conservation at New Jersey's Wetlands Institute. While the crabs spend most of their lives deep underwater, they surface in late spring and early summer to lay their eggs.
So they're depositing eggs into the sand. She has some males that are coming along with her.
An estimated 40 million horseshoe crabs live in the bay, although they can be found all along the Atlantic coast.
Horseshoe crabs have been around for over 450 million years.
Further up the beach, Tony Rose Tablante works with the American Littoral Society.
So there's that like sweet spot like right here.
Teaching volunteers how to tag select crabs for tracking.
Sorry.
Frequently described as living fossils, these resilient, bizarre-looking armored creatures have survived numerous mass extinction events.
They are arthropods, and that's why they're more closely related to scorpions and spiders, and they're not actually crabs.
Horseshoe crab, not a crab.
Horseshoe crab, not a crab.
Not really a horse either.
Yeah.
A female can lay 4,000 eggs a night.
You can see some of the eggs that have washed up and come to the surface. So these
They're tiny.
But only the ones that stay buried in the sand have a chance of hatching. When the tide inevitably unearths the rest, it turns into a feeding frenzy.
So it seems like we're not the only people who know that there are eggs here. It seems like there's some other species that have figured that out.
Right.
Migratory shorebirds depend on the surface eggs and fly thousands of miles to eat them. Birds like the red knot, which makes a perfectly timed pit stop in the Delaware Bay to refuel on its journey from South America to the Arctic. And where there are birds, there are birders. Seeing this migration in person is a bucket list activity for Jay Bolden. But while birding is just a hobby for him, his professional life is also linked to the crabs.
I just noticed this, actually.
Yeah.
You've got a crab pen?
Yeah, it's been our mascot.
As a senior biologist with the Eli Lilly Company, Bolden is very familiar with a medical marvel flowing underneath the horseshoe crab shells.
This is LAL. This is purified horseshoe crab blood.
Limulus amebocyte lysate, made from the bright blue blood of horseshoe crabs, is used to detect dangerous endotoxins in medicine.
Have all of us benefited from horseshoe crab blood?
Sure, if you've gotten a vaccine. Anything that comes in contact with that medicine has to be shown to be free of endotoxin.
While bacterial endotoxins can be found everywhere, you don't want to put them straight into your bloodstream. That could make you sick or potentially even kill you. Horseshoe crab blood reacts to the presence of endotoxins, which is why for decades, LAL has been used to test all sorts of medicines, syringes, and implantable medical devices. Before this method was developed, scientists tested with live rabbits.
Every pharmaceutical company, every manufacturer, everyone's using this?
Anyone making an injectable is using it, so it's widely spread.
The actual collecting and bleeding of crabs is done by LAL manufacturers like Lonza and Charles River Laboratories. While live crabs are returned to the water after their blood is drawn, inevitably some do die in the collection process. But it's difficult to know the total impact.
They throw it in the water and they say, you know, that crab lived. They have no idea that crab's going to live.
So you're looking for a better procedure then, if they are going to bleed it.
We want better practices. So that's a female.
Wildlife biologist Larry Niles is the co-founder of the Horseshoe Crab Recovery Coalition, which advocates for increased transparency in the bleeding industry. He's been studying crabs since the late 1980s.
How have you seen the crab population decline?
So we best measure that by the eggs, because that's the most direct connection with the birds. Mm-hmm. And so the eggs have gone down by about 90%.
In the 1990s, there was a bait boom that led to a significant decline after fishermen started using the plentiful horseshoe crabs to catch eels and whelk.
They parked by the beach and just take every crab that was coming ashore. Within 2 years, they were taking 2.5 million crabs a year. And almost right away, our egg density started crashing.
While horseshoe crabs are still used as bait today, the harvest is now better regulated. State by state, there are a patchwork of protections which address bait and bleeding. Still, the Center for Biological Diversity and 22 partner organizations are actively trying to get the horseshoe crab listed as an endangered species, in part due to how many other species, like the threatened red knots, depend on them. The bait industry, significant habitat loss, sea level rise, all pose challenges. At least in the biomedical world, there's change on the horizon.
The reason I'm hopeful is because synthetic. Synthetic is a very important advance.
So you mix these in a certain ratio?
That's where Jay Bolden and his lab come in. Bolden's been working to get Eli Lilly and his colleagues at other companies to use a synthetic alternative to horseshoe crab blood, originally discovered in Singapore.
Is the synthetic just as good as the real deal?
It is. It's the biochemical equivalent.
Eli Lilly's now converted 80% of its testing to use the synthetic product.
I knew the impact of the birds, I knew the impact of the crabs, and it was something that we can make a positive change.
But change doesn't come quickly. Testing old products with new methods requires new regulatory approvals. In the lab, pictures of the crabs and birds remind the scientists why they're making the switch.
Rabbits protected us for 40 years. Horseshoe crabs have protected us for 40 years. 40 years from now, we won't need to be impacting animals to do this test.
In the meantime, every crab counts, which is why Lisa Ferguson and this group of trained volunteers are walking along the Delaware Bay, turning over toppled crabs to help make sure they get back to the water after spawning. The effort is called Return the Favor.
So you feel like they have done us a favor?
They've done us a favor, so we're returning that favor.